Hey, so Azure Advisor gives me personalized recommendations based on a well-architected framework so I can better use my cloud resources. Why don't we take a look? So let's go to Advisor, right over here. And I'm going to click on All Recommendations. Well, this Advisor recommendation says, consider increasing the size of your NVA to address persistent high CPU. I have no idea what that means. If only I could go to some sort of Advisor clinic. You know, maybe I can. Well, I have Travis Maier here. Maybe he can help me. Hey, Travis, I'm looking at the incomprehensible recommendation. What exactly is an NVA? Let's start there.
Yeah, no problem, David. So a network virtual appliance is a fancy word for a firewall. And Azure obviously offers their own, built-in firewall, fully integrated into the service. But many of our customers want to use a third-party firewall. So maybe we can take a look at some of the different options that we offer as far as firewalls go. There are many reasons that a customer may choose to use a third-party firewall. Some of our most popular vendors are here on the screen. You can have companies like Barracuda, Palo Alto Networks, and Checkpoint, for example. And oftentimes what we find is that customers are very targeted in the way that they want their firewalls to operate. And in many ways, they want to replicate what they have on premise, or they may be working with a third party, right? A managed service provider, an MSP is an example, where they need to have very specific rules in place, very specific functionality, and they want to have parity across maybe on-premise, other clouds, as well as Azure. And so what we're attempting to do with this recommendation in particular is help to monitor these critical workloads, right? If a firewall goes down for any reason or is impacted by performance, in this case, high CPU, it can be very detrimental. So we can have high CPU that's leading into packet loss, and it can affect applications in many different ways, requiring a ton of different types of troubleshooting. So for this recommendation, what we're doing is monitoring the overall theme that we're seeing and the telemetry that we're getting back from these appliances deployed in Azure. And we're trying to see the average CPU usage. If that goes above 90% for a sustained period of time, we will fire this recommendation to proactively alert customers about the situation.
Okay, Travis, so I think I understand this now. How do I start to investigate this issue?
Yeah, sure thing, David. So I think it's important to consider that we have individual agreements with these vendors so that they're in marketplace, right? And within the marketplace, we have individual templates that can be used to deploy all of these different vendor services, especially the firewalls in this case, automatically. So within those, you'll see different options for the size of the VMs, which is typically going to dictate the CPU thresholds that you have available to you. So it's very traditional troubleshooting in that sense. You can take a look within the actual resource, understand what processes may be running, what may be consuming that CPU. You can check the templates that are already deployed. In addition to that, obviously reaching out to your vendor who's very familiar with the exact configuration in Azure is always a good practice as well.
Okay, that makes total sense to me. And now this thing is much less mysterious. So thank you, Travis. That now makes total sense to me, and I really appreciate it. I want to thank you for watching this episode of Azure Advisor Clinic as part of the Azure Enablement Show. I hope you'll join us for future episodes.